women allowed.
Hey, what's up, guys? You're watching Nail That Tone, a series that's all about helping you guys achieve some of the most legendary tones of all time. In this episode, we're talking about Nuno Bettencourt and the Extreme 2 album tone. There's a lot to talk about in this video, so let's get to it. What's up, guys? Today, we're talking about Nuno Bettencourt and his awesome tone from the Extreme 2 album, and definitely one of my favorite tones. So the first thing I want to really talk about is Nuno's kind of unique guitar style, and this really has to do with the whole concept of finger tone, because a lot of your tone does come from the way you play and your style. So in this episode, I really wanted to highlight Nuno's use of this like muted legato that he was very good at, getting it to sound like cool, and he had this very unique way of doing it. So in order to highlight the importance of that, I actually recorded a unplugged kind of version of the riff, and I'm playing it to the best of my ability, trying to recreate that Nuno Bettencourt like muted like legato thing that he's very good at. Anyway, guys, I hope that can really highlight the importance, if you're trying to really play Nuno styles, that you really have to get that kind of muted legato sound down. So now we're talking about the gear that was used on the album. We certainly benefit from the experience and knowledge that is shared by the actual producer and engineer of this album, which is Michael Wagner. Of course, a very legendary producer, if you know anything about that. And so he's very open on different form sites and is always open to sharing his knowledge, which is super cool for us fans, because there's a lot of information about this album and how it was recorded. So I'm just gonna share a little bit about that with you guys. So obviously the main core of the sound was the ADA MP1, which I am fortunate enough to have one, and super cool classic unit from the late 80s, early 90s, very popular at the time. Like Michael Wagner states in his post, that he used the preset 45, which is same preset I use for my tone, and I'll share the settings with this particular presets on the screen with you guys. And pretty much said he just kind of kept it stock. Pretty much the core of that album was the ADA MP1. And the next part of the sound was a Macintosh power amp, which is kind of a hi-fi stereo kind of power amp, which is something maybe you wouldn't associate with guitar kind of stuff, but that's what he says he used. And obviously I don't have one, or else I would have used it on this particular video, but definitely a cool power amp for sure. That's what was used on the record in terms of the power amp. And for guitars, I'm assuming that Nuno Bettencourt was probably using some kind of Washburn, because I know at the time he was known for using them. And I think his signature guitar came out around that time, around 90, 91, 92. So definitely a cool guitar, and definitely a part of the sound. Now when it comes to cabs, from the research I did, looks like they probably use some kind of Marshall cabinet with either the 75 watt speakers or the 30 watt speakers. I'm pretty sure it was the 30 watts, but I'd have to kind of go back and check out those posts again to really make sure. I'm pretty sure it was some kind of 30 watt speaker. That's pretty much the core of the sound. Now, there is one more little thing that was used on the record that is pretty important that I actually don't have here, is the BBE Sonic Maximizer, which is pretty much like a rack unit that was popular during that late 80s, early 90s. And it's pretty much a unit that kind of messes with the phase of your sound and can kind of brighten up and make your sound a little bit like clearer, but it can also kind of jack up the bass. And so it's kind of a slight EQ thing, but it kind of messes with the phase. Again, I have played through one, but I don't currently own one right now, and I probably should, because they're generally usually pretty cheap. You can find them for $50 sometimes, so I'll definitely get one in the near future. But I did not have one for this particular video, but that was clearly stated as part of the sound that they use, was a BBE Sonic Maximizer. So pretty cool little unit, but I don't currently have one. So when it comes to the gear that I use, again, as you guys can see, I have the 88 MP1, and I have it set to, of course, preset number 45. I kept everything stock, just left it the way the settings say on the Michael Wagner post. And for power amps, I use my Rectifier 2100 or Mesa Boogie power amp. And it's really cool power amp, super heavy and loud, but I use this particular one because I have some other solid state power amps, but I don't feel that they're as nice or as cool as this one. So this one's all tube, and I used it on the normal setting because it also has a rectifier kind of more modern setting. So I kept it normal because I didn't want it to color the sound in any way. So just use that. Uses the 6L6 power tube. So that's what I used for my power amp. And in place of the Sonic Maximizer, I actually just used some EQ and jacked up the bass a bit, made the sound a little bit brighter, and dipped the mids a bit, which is a pretty common thing. And also something I've heard that Nuno likes to do is scoop his mids a bit and then kind of just brighten up the highs and jack up the bass to give you that nice punch. And for guitars, I use my Ibanez Gem Jr. Because of the fact that it's kind of an 80s guitar and it also has the Floyd, I felt that it was the closest guitar that I own to the kind of Washburn signature Nuno guitar. And for cabinets, I use my Marshall 1960 V vintage with the vintage sturdies in it. So again, I'm not exactly sure if that's what they use, but I think any Marshall cabinet would be pretty similar to what they used. And in terms of replacements, if you guys don't own 88 MP1 or any of this kind of stuff, I would say a good replacement for the preamp would be pretty much any kind of Marshall type of sound, I think, because the tone that I hear on this album is slightly more gain than an average Marshall. Pretty much, I would describe the gain structure of the 88 MP1 as a sort of modified Marshall sound, so it has a little bit more gain than you would find in your typical JCM 800, so if you have any kind of Marshall, I would say that's, you're pretty close. You just maybe adding a tad bit more of gain, either with like a boost or a distortion pedal would get you pretty close. And in terms of power amp, I would use, you know, any kind of tube power amp, because that's pretty similar to the Macintosh. And for cabinets, any kind of Marshall cabinet should do, or anything with some quality speakers should get you pretty close. And in terms of microphones, I just use your traditional SM57. Anyway, guys, that's pretty much it for this video. If you like this video and learn some cool stuff about this tone and about Nuno Bettencourt, go ahead and hit that like button and consider subscribing, because we release videos like these on a weekly basis. So hopefully, guys, we'll see you in the next video.